Hey guys and gals, this is Brad Edwards with Elite Marine Works, and the channel is known as Boat Works. This is my first YouTube video, so try to make it interesting for you guys. Today I've got a 40-foot Invincible. It's a 2020, beautiful boat, quad 400 Mercs, and the starboard outboard motor is causing an issue. It's stumbling, don't know why. I have an idea that it's probably a fuel siphon pickup. Found that on the inner starboard about a month ago. And I'm gonna take you guys through this ride. If you would, smash the like button and please subscribe. This is my first YouTube video, and hopefully I make it interesting for you guys. If you've got any questions, please hit me up. Other than that, let's go for this ride in the boat, and I'll see you over there. Alright, I just got this one to break free. I'm pulling it out. This is port side feeder. I've already done these other three. And what are we going to find? We're finding an extremely loose fuel connection that lets air come in around this collar. The fix, cut about a half inch to that ring line basically off of this tube. And what I'll do is I'll pull this off of here just like so, which comes off very easily. Clean around this a little. Nice and clean now on there. Stuff to get into anything on the fuel system. As you can see, there was that white residue, and that was from fuel when it does siphon up, seeping out around the collar. So what I'm gonna do again, as I said before, is get about a half inch, it's right to that ring line basically, and cut that off. That. Now, what I'll do is, that's clean, we'll push this down into that nice and flat and full. And as you can see, it's extremely tight now. I say extremely, but it is a nice, tight, snug fit. It's not going anywhere. So, this is the fix to that problem. And what's happening is every time I cut a half inch off of this, it's raising the siphon and the screen at the bottom of it a half inch from the base of this tank. The volume of these tanks, that makes a big difference. Not a big difference, but it does make a difference on if you ever got into a situation where these tanks were about run dry. Well, you're going to have a little more fuel in there now, of which you could have been running on in a bad situation. Wouldn't have been a whole lot, but it could have been enough. At any rate, there needs to be a fix from this, from Invincible, and some sort of collar, clamp, something to go on this. But I'm fixing it the way I know right now, other than maybe putting epoxy on it, but I don't want to do anything unless Invincible directs it. This was done by Invincible. I'm putting it back on the way it was done by Invincible until told different from them. So that's my two cents.
Dropping the Invincible in the water after we just tried to fix the fuel tank siphon tubes that were really loose.
What we are suspecting is a squared away repair on the starboard tank siphon pickups in the tank, where the collars wobble. The siphon tubes are so long that they wobble with all the fuel sloshing back and forth in there. And it makes the tubes, it wallows out the tops of the tubes around the collar, the neck of that pickup at the top of the tank, where it 90s out of the tank. But what it was doing was making these, making the starboard out, the outside starboard motor was shaking, acting like a pencil coil, or a spark plug was fouled out, or a pencil coil bad, and or an FMS pump there. But we're gonna take the boat out and give it a little test ride here. Hopefully this resolves the issue. I know the owner did say that it was happening also in reverse, so I'm gonna pull it out of gear here, and I'm gonna put these motors starboard side in reverse and see if this motor starts acting like that. And so far, I'm not getting anything like what he was saying is happening. So with that, and on that note, we're gonna go ahead and take this thing out for a ride, because he was saying it was happening at high speed. And then they'd slow down and start doing some trolling or deep drop. They had to go in reverse. That starboard outer motor would shake like a leaf in reverse, and like a idle to trolling, it would shake and shudder. And then at high speed, it would do it as well. And you can feel it in the boat, but he said it would clear up after a few minutes. I say a few minutes, it could be 10 minutes, but he did say it would clear up. And so in order to figure this out, once we've done this fix, hopefully this has resolved the issue. And then we'll put the boat up and let the owner know what we did to fix it. And
be enough, they see the money I'm making. Is it true what they telling me? Every in LA when a hook or rap dress like me, don't call back cause I'm cool with it. Hit once then I'm done. Have fun, I need a new feeling. Still let a little thing you do. When it's late, you can slide through. Bring a friend too.
Beautiful day. Seem to be running good. I am getting a shake. I believe it's out of the inner port at an idle. So I have a feeling I need to pull up this hatch and check these siphon tubes. It's probably the same issue that was going on with the starboard side. Starboard's clean now, no issues at all. I'm gonna bust a little reverse, pull out of gear here, and do a little reverse action with the starboard side. Let's see. Oh, she's good. No issues on the starboard. So got the Invincible back here, and the issue with the engines is resolved on the starboard side here with the fuel system. And I just wanted to give you guys an update. It's a beautiful boat, without a doubt, and a very great client to us, and definitely takes care of us. But I'm gonna clean her up, put her up, and get down the road to the next job. So besides that, you guys have a great day, and we'll see you later.